doing all this and why? And what are we supposed to do about it? There are many people involved in the plans for the new world order. We have the United Nations. We have the World Council of Churches. We have the Council of Foreign Relations. You want to get more on that? There's the Trilateral Commission, the Bilderbergers, the International Monetary Fund, IMF, the International Bankers, the Club of Rome, the Communists, the Socialists, the National Education Association, NEA, the Masonic Lodge. Most of the guys that I know in the Masonic Lodge, including some very close friends of mine, don't really have a clue what they're in. They don't realize till they get to the top it's a satanic organization. I'll show you. Here's the oath. General Pike said, "That which we must say to the crowd is, we worship a God, but it's a God that one adores without superstition. To you, Sovereign Grand Inspectors General, we say this, that you may repeat it to the 32nd, 31st, and 30th degrees. The Masonic religion should be, by all of us initiates of the higher degrees, maintained in the purity of the Luciferian doctrine, lest, yes, Lucifer is God." I think it's time to get motivated, folks. There's a real serious problem coming, looming on the horizon. We're going to see real serious trouble in America. What do we do? Well, the first mention of Caesar in the Bible is in Matthew 22:17. "Tell us, therefore, what thou thinkest. Is it lawful to give tribute unto Caesar or not?" Jesus was born under Caesar's control. What did he do? He ignored him. Just go win souls. So 12 things we need to do. Number one, you need to realize God's in control. He's the potter. We are the clay. Shut up. Sit still. Let him do something with you. Okay? Be still and know that he is God. Let him put you where he wants you and make out of you what he wants, whatever he wants to make out of you. Out of you. He's the potter. Number two, be wise as serpents. I think we stick our head in a lot of nooses and let them hang us. And we could talk a long time about all the different ways that we have created a nexus of relationship with the government. Churches do that by getting 501c3. People do that by getting marriage licenses and driver's licenses and social security numbers. Number three, be careful for nothing. Careful means full of care. I see people that are worried and nervous. Wow, what's going to happen? The New World Order's coming. They're going to come kill everybody. Well, go win some souls. Number four, pray for those in authority. We're his children, obey his orders, preach the gospel. Be the salt of the earth. Salt irritates. Some of these Christians are so worried about offending somebody. Who cares? I want to please God. Nothing else is going to matter, folks. Use your influence. Everybody has influence. Money doesn't dictate right and wrong. If it does, you got a problem. You do what's right. God takes care of it from there.